Sitting in the company of three other women, Evelyn Amony is carefully knitting an African fabric. She breaks her pace to recall how she was abducted at the age of 12 in 1994 by the LRA rebels and later forced to become a wife to the warlord Joseph Kony. Evelyn Amony gave birth to three children with Joseph Kony. Unfortunately, one child, the second born, went missing in 2004, exactly 1 year before she returned home.
We are 27 wife. For him, he don't have time for carry baby. But sometimes escort, they help me. In the bush, life is time. Life is very hard. Sometimes you stay 2 weeks without eating. Sometimes 3 days without taking water.
For one decade, from the late 1980s to the late 1990s, many young girls were abducted across Acholi, Lango, Teso, and parts of West Nile and Karamoja. They were forcefully made wives to the LRA rebel commanders.
And the child I came with, that child, I don't know their home or their land. Yes. Right now, we don't know our places. We don't have land. We have children. So I think the ICC, they are wasting their time for Kony.
Even if they get Kony, even if they start prosecuting when it's not there, it's not going to change anything. It will not change anybody's life. I think the only thing is just to work on the people which the damage fell on them, like those people who are injured, people maybe who have died, they died and then they left the orphans, these children, and then the children who are born in captivity.
It is a difficult period in their lives that they have learned to accept. But as they talk about the Joseph Kony charges to be heard in his absence by the ICC, Evelyn Amony believes that the focus should rather be on how to support the victims.
Now, your firstborn is with you or is the one who got lost?
He's with me. The secondborn is the one got lost.
As Evelyn Amony returned home in 2005, another prominent woman was Andruvile Joly Okot, who was in the thick for the mediation between the LRA rebels and the government of Uganda.
Joly Grace Okot Andruvile is another former LRA abductee who spent 2 years in captivity. She later founded the Invisible Children organization to highlight the human suffering caused by the LRA war. She strongly believes that money led to the breakdown of the peace talks between the Joseph Kony-led LRA and the Ugandan government.
Personally, I talked to Joseph Kony and he said, you know what, this peace agreement I think will work. Now you need to begin bringing clothing for your children there. Something that I am so bold and I know did not make this peace process to succeed was money.
At the height of the Juba peace talks, Joly Grace Lake Okot Andruvile notes that the great powers of the international community have been relaxed in putting an end to the LRA war, even after joining hands with American film director Jason Russell. Her efforts have been in vain.
This trial, it would have been nice if the ICC could bring the real Joseph Kony seated there and we hear his voice. And as a commander-in-chief of the LRA, why things happened the way it happened. Of course, he denies a lot of it. But also, when you are close to Joseph Kony, there's a certain part in him that you wouldn't even think. He did not, like today, when you ask how many people he personally killed, you can't tell. And no one will stand in the dock to actually be a witness of that.
These mothers believe that repatriation and reparation should be the pillars that the ICC lays its groundwork as it seeks to try Joseph Kony.
Chidong pa konye pingo ICC uchak nero kirmi konyo victims.
From my interaction here, Joseph Kony would have ended the LRA war had the government of Uganda met his demands for a home, school for his children, and a sustainable stream of income.
The confirmation of the charges by the judges at the ICC is all that is remaining. But according to what I have heard from the people on ground here, it is a lost cause. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu.